sec. Can I go get to work?
Listen, I'm sorry about the way things played out between Chloe and Dave.
Yeah, I bet.
I am, mate. I'm serious. Yeah.
Except you obviously knew about the kiss before I did.
No, I didn't.
Which is fine. You're Team Theo. I get it. But just don't pretend that you care.
It's not like that, mate.
I don't want to hear it, okay? I don't want your opinion.
Oh, you should have heard her singing his praises. Her interviewing though, they've so much in common.
She doesn't know who she's doing.
He's got her completely fooled. Oh, what am I going to do?
I know what I'd like to do.
Artie.
I know, I'll stay away from him. But it's what he deserves.
Yeah, even so. Having you down on an assault charge, it's not going to help anyone.
Maybe we'll just tell her the truth.
No.
Well, maybe I should have another word with him. Just a word. See some boundaries.
Matthew's a barrister.
Yeah, that'd be a blow light.
We have to be smart about this. If we make a mistake now, we're just going to push Chloe further away. Hey! Thanks for coming back. I really wanted to talk more.
No problem. Thanks for texting. But you are working, so is this a bad time?
No, that's okay. I'll just take my break now. Where are you now? Perhaps Madam would like a raise as well.
Now that you mention it. And I'll just settle for my break.
Pretty quiet now. Knock yourself out. So, is she pretty?
I'm Matthew.
I'm Irene. Seen you around here quite a bit lately.
Chloe making best coffee in town.
Always good to get positive feedback.
That's the truth.
So how come you two know each other?
You gave me her business card.
Oh, God's sake. Seriously. Memory like a sieve. Of course I do.
That's okay. I've got a few clients in hospitality and I just wanted to hear more about Chloe's business.
Well, she's quite the entrepreneur, this one.
Big things in the future.
Oh, this is embarrassing. I'm only just starting out.
Well, I'll look at that. Modest as well. Enjoy yourself, darling.
Since I'm here, I thought maybe we could have a chat.
Well, I said all I need to say.
Well, I'd like to talk about what happened with Mackenzie before and why you thought it was okay to go on with that.
I have every right to tell her how I feel. And I don't need you following me around apologising to people.
Okay. You're right. I overstepped and I'm sorry. You were really full on. Listen, why don't we have dinner? You know, because we never got to have that lunch.
I know what you're doing. You think I can't look after myself?
No, I just thought you'd like the company. Oh, come on, it's my show. It's my way of saying I'm sorry.
By ignoring my wishes.
I can get us some from Seoul. We can just sit, eat, and talk.
Sounds good to me. I'm starving.
Mr. Stewart?
You don't sound so surprised, Marilyn. It is my flaming house.
It's good to see you too, love.
I'm just here to pick up a takeaway.
Listen, I'm sorry for blowing up at you before. It wasn't fair on you.
You don't need to apologise. For what it's worth, I think Theo's in the wrong.
Thanks.
Hey, hi, Ryder. I'm really sorry about you and Chloe breaking up.
Yeah, me too. Guess it was inevitable.
Yeah, have you spoken to her lately?
Well, I tried talking to her before my shift.
Yeah? How did that go? Is she okay?
Well, it turns out she's got more important things to worry about. But telling her business partner that she cancelled all of last night's orders isn't one of them. Another unhappy customer.
Sorry.
It's not your fault. It's Chloe who's got the problem with the truth.
Always been pretty clear on how she feels. She wasn't going to restore it.
I know where you're going with this. I've told you, I'm not telling her.
I don't like it either, but what other options do we have?
I'm not telling daughter, she's a product of assault.
Look, if she knew the truth, Matthew will be out of our lives for good.
Yeah, but at what cost? Think about how this will affect her, Arnie, how she thinks about herself.
Right now she thinks you lied to her, her whole life, because of a teenage grudge.
What Chloe thinks about herself is actually more important than how she thinks about me.
Even if we lose her.
I don't want her to think she's unwanted, or that I resent her in any way, because I don't. I couldn't. I never could.
I know. So does she.
Once something like this is said, it can't be unsaid. It'll be with her forever.
Thank you, mate.
Oh, yes, thank you for that.
Chloe's charm. She can deal with this.
You don't know that.
She's getting around this guy without all the information. It's not fair. If she finds out from someone else, do you really think she's going to forgive me?
I'm sorry to hear Marcus Dolomar. Yeah, Ruth's talking to the doctors now about her options.
Do you know what? We need a distraction. I'll get the paper off the veranda and we'll get you the crossway.
All right, mate, what's going on? I mean, what are you doing here?
I could ask you the same thing. I heard a voice message from Marilyn and she sounded terrified. But now that I'm back here, she seems okay. Trust me, she had been on her best behavior since she walked through the door. I don't follow her. She's been a real handful ever since she left hospital.
Well, what do you mean a handful?
Confrontational. She's pushing everyone away. And then she turns up to my place and basically moves herself in.
Are we talking about the same Marilyn?
A lot's happened since you've been away.
Found it! Here we go. I reckon we can get that done before bed. What do you reckon, eh?
Yeah, sure.
Am I interrupting something?
No. Actually, I should probably get going.
Oh, no tea? I was about to put the kettle on.
It's getting late. You two have probably got a lot to catch up on.
Oh, well, thank you for doing that, Justin. It was lovely.
Glad you liked it.
See you, mate.
All right.
Night.
Right, Marilyn, I reckon this time we had a chat.
This is about my voicemail, isn't it?
You did seem pretty upset.
Well, I wasn't. But that happens to us all every now and again.
Well, we've been through a lot. Sometimes these things can creep up on us when we least expect it.
Yes. But I'm feeling much better now that you're here. I am sorry I took you away from you.
Don't be silly, love. You should know by now that I'm always going to be there for you, no matter what.
Thank you, Mr. Stewart. I'll put the kettle on, eh? Get started.
Sounds good to me.
Anyway, it turns out I was in the wrong room the whole time.
Are all judges so mean?
Well, to be fair, I was horribly underprepared.
I'm guessing you must be crazy.
Yeah. Hey, I gotta ask. What have you told your mother?
She knows we've hung out. And talked.
Gonna go well then.
I don't care what my mum thinks. My mother should do.
Love, I hate to be party poop now, but I could really use a hand cleaning up.
Sure. Yeah, it has been a pretty long day.
It was great catching up.
It really was.
Guess what I've been doing all day?
You mean other than annoying me?
Getting phone calls from angry customers after you cancelled last night's orders without telling me. Your business partner.
I was having a bad night.
Why wouldn't you tell me?
Because I forgot.
Well, like how you forgot to tell me you kissed Theo?
Can we not do this here?
When I cancelled on you, I at least had the decency to call you.
I was dealing with some real issues. You burned your finger in some challenge.
I was trying to pay off our debt, the one that you seem to have forgotten about.
Could I forget the one thing keeping me shackled?
Shackled? Mate, you need to settle down. And I think you owe Chloe an apology.
And who are you?
He's my dad. Babe, I'm thinking of going big.
Hey, morning. I made extra eggs if you want some.
Sorry, I'm in a rush. Where are you going? Al?
Chloe.
You really don't want to know, so let's not go there.
Fine. We need to talk.
I'm done talking about this.
Well, you need to listen, because I've got a lot to say.
You're on Mum's side. You want me to have nothing to do with my real dad? What a shock. Chloe?
This isn't about taking sides. This is much bigger than that.
is that? But he's my biological dad. What possible reason could you have for not wanting me to see him? Unless you're jealous?
No.
What is it then? If it's the big secret, I mean, it can't be any bigger than, like, oh, I'm sorry, I just never told your dad you exist. Thank you. I'm not saying anything.
It's not my place. But she's asking questions, so we've got to tell something at some stage.
A miracle worker, eh?
I agree. Marilyn was completely normal over dinner.
You don't reckon she's bunging it on for his sake, do you?
It wouldn't surprise me. But the fact that she called out to him for help, that's got to be a good thing.
True. It's not so good for Alf, is it? Having to leave Martha like that. I just hope that she's upfront with him about exactly what's been going on.
Me too.
I can't help you here, Marilyn.
Oh, don't you dare to finger. This is my treat.
Yeah, I was thinking when we're finished here, we might take a stroll over to the bait shop and see what's going on there. It'd feel like a walk.
Oh, that'd be lovely. Thanks, Mr. Stewart.
Oh, about time. I thought I was going to have to drag you out by the ear. Good to see you too, Grumps. Marilyn's cooking up a storm. Why don't you pull up a few, eh? You can tell me what I've missed.
I'd love to, but I can't. Thanks, mate.
Oh, well, never mind. More for Mr. Stewart.
What's the hurry? You're late for work.
I wish. Probably wants to chat. Apparently she's got good news.
Oh, are you two back together again?
Please, my total blunt punishment. Right, see ya.
Bye-bye. Bye. I hope everything's all right there. Young love, you're complicated.
Right, you seem full of beans this morning, Marilyn.
Well, I had a really good sleep last night, and I feel like a new woman today.
I'm pleased to hear that. You had me worried with that phone call.
Mr. Stewart, that was just a wobble. Honestly, I'm...
I think it's time that we sever the ties. It's my half of the money that we owe.
Where did this come from?
Doesn't matter. I've paid off my share of the debt, agreed?
I guess.
Great. How much will it cost to buy you out of business?
You want my share of underlay?
Well, I don't want to work with you anymore, so yes, I want your share.
Well, what if I don't want to be bought out? We built that business together. I still think we make a good team.
You don't. We're a disaster.
Well, if that's how you feel, then you can just have my share. I don't want your money.
You must want something.
No. Business was your idea. I was only ever a part of it to build a future with you. So take it.
You'll need to sign off. Any claim to business name and intellectual property.
You should hear yourself, right?
I'll get the paperwork drawn up. Do we have a deal? Then I think we're done here.
Yeah, we're done.
Hello. Everything all right there?
Yeah. Finally clear and breathing.
Oh, okay. Wow. Well, I'm happy if you're happy. But what about your business and the debt?
It's all taken care of.
Oh yeah? How did you manage that?
It's a long story, but I'm debt-free and underlays online once I get the paperwork sorted.
Chloe, how did you pay off the debt?
Mackie gave you the money, didn't he? What, you're just accepting money from strangers now, are you?
He's not a stranger.
Yeah, no, well, he is. You don't really know him. It was a gift. Okay, to make up for the years that he missed with me because of you. Chloe, can't you see? He's trying to buy his way into your life.
You're wrong. And he's already in my life, and actually, you're just saying that.
If you and Ryder aren't working, I thought I could fire up the barbie and we could have a catch up over dinner.
Lovely. Stuart, I mean, I can't speak for Ryder, but now that I'm in between jobs, I'm as free as a bird.
You're what?
Oh, didn't I tell you I don't work here?
What the hell happened?
Well, when I got out of hospital, I didn't feel very supported and everyone was being very judgmental, so I left.
So by everyone, you mean Irene and Leah?
Mostly, Irene.
Marilyn, you've always worked here.
Yes, but maybe it was time for a change. I mean, nothing lasts forever.
I'll get us a cup, right?
Okay. Thanks. Oh, good. I heard you were back.
Don't forget about that rubbish. Why did you let Marilyn go?
Well, actually, we didn't get much to say in the matter.
You're supposed to be friends.
I don't know what Lady Luck's been saying to you, but it's obvious that you don't know the full story.
Yeah, well, what I do know is that she's been through the flame and ringer, and a fair dinkum mates wouldn't be so quick to judge her.
Oh, come off it out. Blind Freddie can see that she's not herself.
Well, she seems all right to me. I don't know what everyone's carrying on about.
Give me a couple of minutes, and then you and me are going to sit down and have a little chat. Here goes Anna.
Matthew? What are you doing here?
I've come to see my daughter.
He's just picking me up, okay? We're leaving. No, Chloe, you're not going anywhere with him. Mum, stay out of it.
Look, I'm not here to cause any trouble, guys. There's a guy trying to buy his daughter.
That's not what he's doing.
I told you to stay away from my family.
You don't intimidate me.
Well, then for a lawyer, you're not very smart.
How are you doing?
Get in the house.
Don't
talk to her like that.
You don't get to tell me what to do. Are you sure I get a say in your life?
Buddy.
You need to leave.
You can threaten me all you like, but Chloe is my daughter, and there is nothing you can do about it.
Buddy.
You just made a big mistake. Chloe, come with me. It's not safe.
Get away from her!
I'm not helping! How dare you do this to my family?
I know Ari's done time. I just want to know my daughter. So either you let that happen or press charges and I'll send your boyfriend back to prison.